Welcome to the SOTI video series. My name is Richard Fitzsimmons and I'm joined by David Easer, both of us senior principal instructors here at SOTI.
And Richard, I believe that in this video, we're ready to just work through the process and steps of enrolling a modern Zebra printer in SOTI Connect, right?
That's right. So let's pick up by looking at the configuration file that's sent to that Zebra device for enrollment, which includes certificate, time, and MQTT information. Wherever the printers are, we just need to make sure that the printers can reach out to wherever the broker is hosted.
And the actual, that you can reach not only that server, but also that you can log in, but also that you can connect and access the services through the port that is listed here, which in this case is port 8883. Now, it is important to know as well that, as I mentioned earlier, when you see mqtt.con1, that's referencing connection number one. If you replace anything that's one in here by a number two, then you can actually configure a secondary connection to a different MQTT server.
Okay, thank you. What I'm going to do is just add an extra return, so an extra space at the end of these commands. This is a recommended route from Zebra, and I'll copy the entire contents, and we can basically get this sent to the printer in question.
Let's do it. Let's take a look how it looks like once it's sent.
Okay, so let's move on to the printer side. So in this case, I'm using a Zebra ZQ320 that we have here, and I'm actually going to be using a tool called Zebra Setup Utilities to configure the printer and to pass the information for MQTT Broker onto the printer. Please note that there are some other tools that can be used, but in this case, we are using Zebra Setup Utilities. If I click on the device, I have this plugged in via USB. This is also the tool that if we needed to, we could upgrade the firmware, download that from the manufacturer, push it to the printer through this tool, along with configuring the printer connectivity. David, as you mentioned earlier on, this printer is either going to need to be wired or connected to Wi-Fi. It needs to have a network presence. It needs to have an IP address.
Mm-hmm. So you can reach that MQTT server.
Once that's done, I'll go for the option of open communication with printer, and it is a case of just pasting in the information that we saw previously from our configuration file, the certificate information, the time information, the broker information, and then saying send to printer.
Now, the beauty of using a tool like this is that you actually get feedback as to what's going on when the actual commands are integrated and sent to the printer, whereas other tools are more quiet. Like if you actually save this as a ZPL file, the configuration that we actually created and send it to a printer, it would automatically execute it and apply those changes, but you won't be able to confirm that it works until you actually go to connect and see if the printer knocks at the door.
That's it. And just a few extra considerations around that. Please note that sometimes these files can have, or all these commands can have, difficulty being sent to the device if, for example, there is an error on the device. So, for example, if the print head is up, or if there isn't paper in the device, that can actually stop the commands being sent. So these are considerations to bear in mind as you are sending these commands to the printer. Now, as you can see here with our MQTT connection information, we have a value, it's called retry interval, and the value of that is set to 120. So essentially this is saying that the printer is going to be looking to connect to the MQTT broker on an ongoing basis every 120 seconds or every 2 minutes. So let's just give this a little bit of the time and we should see that the printer appears in SOTI Connect. So now we've sent this information to the device, we should expect the device to appear within the SOTI Connect console within a few minutes based on the retry connection to the MQTT broker. Now, as we're waiting, just one or two notes on this. An organization has control about how this device appears. So with MQTT, the device can appear in a new device list as soon as it's registered with its broker, and the organization could have the option of reviewing those devices and then manually approving or enrolling them into SOTI Connect. Comparatively, if an organization looks to automate that process, that's also very possible for the SOTI Connect enrollment rules.
Something to consider is that with MQTT devices, the actual discovery process is actually automatic. You don't have to be triggering it. As soon as those devices hit the broker will announce it. Because we are subscribers to that broker, we're going to be announced or told that there's a new device pending for us to be able to approve it in our end. And that is going to be called the enrollment process. The enrollment equals approval in SOTI Connect.
And as I said, after a minute or two, the device appears in SOTI Connect. We have a green tick and we can see that there's a new device added. There we are. That's our Zebra ZQ300 Plus series. That's the device we were using. And we can tick this and approve. And please note, this is the manual approval process, but even this part can be automated if an organization wishes.
And if we want to do that, we just use enrollment rules, which is part of the rules available with SOTI Connect.
There we go. That's the enrollment of a Zebra device using an MQTT broker.
And just remember that depending on the version of the operating system running on the Zebra device, as well as its age, you will be able to either use MQTT as shown in this example, or you may also have the option to use SNMP, which is another way of integrating Zebra devices into SOTI Connect.
Thank you for joining us in this video where we've successfully enrolled a Zebra device into SOTI Connect. Now, all of the visibility and automation benefits of SOTI Connect can be leveraged for this device.
And don't forget, if you haven't yet, subscribe to the SOTI YouTube channel for further tutorials. And for more information about the SOTI One platform, visit us at SOTI.net.